Welcome to another episode of Strategic Minds Making Money Moves, where we talk about strategies to help us to bring in that green. I will tell you, I'm extremely excited today. And you might say, well, aren't you excited all the time? Probably. But you know, today I'm going to have the opportunity to talk to another guest that we had in a previous season, and you may have seen her, Selena Thompson. And she is over Savvy Empire Consulting. And we're going to talk a little bit about the strategies that she implemented, what she did to move forward. Now, I got to let you know, get in on a little secret. The reason I'm so excited is because I actually use her services. I actually asked her, look, I can't do all of this. I need some help. And you're going to understand why by the time we finish this episode. So I'm looking forward to getting more and more information that she can share with you on how she has moved forward. So welcome.
Hello. Happy to be here.
I'm so glad to have you. So for those that may not have seen the previous episode, will you tell them a little bit about your business?
Yes, so the Savvy Empire Consulting is a virtual assistant business. It also focuses on project management. I'm currently in the process of getting my PMP, so I'm super excited about that. But my virtual assistant business is how I started out. And I help people with their administrative duties, with their marketing, with anything that has to do with making sure the business operation will run smooth. That's where I come in. And it's a little bit different this time. I was before the Savvy Apprentice LLC. I switched my business. I changed my name. And now I'm focusing strictly on coaches, life coaches, career coaches, strategic coaches, executive coaches. I think that focusing more on the coaches is my niche, and that's why I revamped my business.
Okay, that's awesome. So we went through a new branding exercise. We'll talk about that in a moment. So why don't you tell us what the strategy was that was given to you and how it began to manifest itself as you were going through this change?
Well, Vicki, previously we talked about like managing my time and having like a portfolio. So when I was doing that, I realized that I found it more productive for me and my business to strictly focus on the coaches. The coaches that I currently have, we work with as far as project management and administrative duties and business operational, those things I really enjoy doing. And I found that if I can go ahead and just switch my times, make sure that because I'm a busy person, I do a lot of things during the day as far as working out and having a 9-to-5. I really had to crunch my time and write down things. I think we talked about like an organizer, which I have like a notebook organizer and an electronic organizer. So that really helped.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. So let's talk a little bit about, so you decided to focus on this niche. What gave you the clues that said, this is really where I need to be? This is what I need to do. Because sometimes we go through this thing of, I'm not sure if I should focus here. I'm not sure if I could focus there. What was it that gave you the insights that said, yes, I enjoy this, and I may enjoy these other things too, but this is truly where I need to focus to move forward?
Well, I really, really enjoy helping people. Coaches, you guys, the strategic coaches, the life coaches, the career coaches, they really are an insight into people's lives. You have to learn about people's lives, and you're trying to help them figure it out like a puzzle. So with that being said, these people that I work with, they help people. They help people make sure that their lives are strategic, that they're writing right plans, that they're doing the right things to move forward. So with all that being said, I enjoy helping people and I love people that help people. So I figured if I can put two and two in that together and continue focusing on my business and growing my business, I think that I hit the jackpot. So, yes.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And you know, one of the things I want you to take from this is listen to the passion. Listen to the dedication of saying, look, I can't be all things to all people. What is the one thing that I really want to do that I can dedicate my time, my energy to? The things that I really want to do to take my business forward, that I can do the sleepless nights over, that, you know, I can dedicate the time that it takes to do it, that I can market those things that I want to do. I can attract the right audience. So you'll notice that she's talking a lot about how I had to refocus. Now, when you talk about your time management and you say that you have a planner as well as electronic, how do you keep them synchronized? What do you do there? How does that work?
Well, I found out that when you need a schedule and your schedule is as crazy as mine, it's probably best to do it weekly. So I will write down my plan weekly in my weekly planner and then translate that to my electronic calendar because things need to be in there to remind me. Everyone loves our phones. So that's what I decided to do, just writing it down. I'm traditional. I love lists. So that's why I help you and I help all my coaches out there. I'm going to write it down. I'm going to make sure I have a list and I'm going to get it done.
And that's the other thing, understanding what works for you. So she talked about, I'm a list person. Knowing that she's a list person and then being able to implement things to utilize that list means that you're going to maximize the time period that you have as you're moving forward and actually trying to implement these things as you're doing. Now, you mentioned you have a full-time job as well. How do you manage the full-time job and building a business? I know there's a lot of entrepreneurs out there that want to get started. They want to just begin that step, but they are working a full-time job and they're trying to figure out, well, how do I get started? What do I do? I would love to get your insights on what that looked like.
It's early mornings. It literally is me waking up at 4:45 a.m. every morning, and that's when I'm looking at my schedule for the day. And sometimes it can be late nights. I do also have two children. So just managing the two children and the 9-to-5, it's a lot of dedication. That's why it's so, so important to make sure you have a schedule and you stick to your schedule. I listen to motivational YouTube videos in the morning. My favorite is David Goggins and Les Brown. So those people, they motivate me. You want to get your mind motivated for the day. I think that's the best thing, is just waking up early. You have to begin early.
Well, we're going to take a station break. And when we come back, we're going to follow up on mindset, because I think that's a very key component of what she talked about. We'll be right back.
Strategic Minds, Making Money Moves, with Vicki Wright Hamilton, focuses on helping entrepreneurs to overcome their business challenges to help increase their bottom line. Each episode provides strategies for growth and transformation. Watch Vicki share her 20-plus years of experience as a corporate executive to help entrepreneurs level up.
Welcome back. So I want to continue, Selena, with the conversation that we were having. You said something very key before we took our station break. And you said mindset. What does mindset mean to you? How did you think about taking these, you know, what I do in the morning and how I get myself prepared? So what is mindset to you?
It's your thoughts. It's your daily thoughts. You need to have that motivation inside of you and prepare yourself. And you have to have those talks. So mindset to me, it basically means to me is you're talking to yourself. You're making sure you're motivating yourself. I'm my biggest cheerleader. That's what it means to me.
Did you hear that? I'm my biggest cheerleader. I have to believe in myself so that I can then therefore have the energy, have the capacity to actually take it forward. But you also said, I have a full-time job and I'm a mom. And you know, I think this is something we really have to talk about, because time is something that everybody is concerned about. I don't have enough of it. So how do you get your exercise in, deal with the kids, make sure they're not missing out, work your job? You said you get up early in the morning to start working on things for your business. Mm-hmm. How does that work?
Well, a lot of time blocking, I think, is the key there. I have, like I said, my schedule, my organizer, and I do a lot of time blocking. And I'm, like I said, checking the daily schedule every day is very important in the morning. And in the morning, for me, it works for me to work out in the morning. Again, that's my motivation time. I'm listening to my YouTube videos. So I do work out in the morning. I feel like I get that out of the way for the day. And then I refocus myself to work on, you know, being in the office or working on other things that I have to accomplish. But I do get that workout in the beginning of the day, along with setting my mindset, figuring out how the day is going to go, whether it's ballet practice or swimming. I'm making sure I have my time blocks after 5 p.m. and sometimes in between the day.
Do you think you get enough sleep?
No.
And I say that on purpose because there is a give and take. And when you're building, you know, there are moments when we don't get enough rest, right? And we have to sometimes figure out, wait a minute, I have to slow down a little bit. I need to get some more rest because we don't want our bodies to then reverse on us and say, hey, wait a minute, I'm tired. I can't do this anymore, right? So it is important that we begin to build that balance in. And I'm glad that you're now looking at that planner. So within the week, you can try to do a little bit more balance as you're moving forward. And when we talk about time, how do you know when you're at capacity? Do you start, I'm going to get three clients. I'm going to get four clients. I'm going to get five clients. How do you determine what that capacity is in terms of working your business?
Well, I determined that originally a long time ago, probably when I first started. And that is what I'm comfortable with, my stress level. I know I need to have at least 5 to 6 hours of sleep, and that's bare minimum. So anything that's going to take me over that or over the time with my children, because that's also very important, we do have a time block, like at 7, I'm winding down. And I know it seems really tight, but if you have a great schedule, you can get everything done within 4:45 in the morning and 7 p.m. at night. So I make sure that that is taken care of first. It's important.
That's good. That's good. And I will say her deliverables are on time and of great quality. So, you know, I will tell you that. So you obviously manage it very, very well, you know, as you're moving forward and the things that you're doing. So I want to get back to your changing your name.
Yes.
So what inspired you to change your brand name?
Well, actually, what inspired me is first when I was here, I decided that I wanted to focus my business a little bit more on project management. I'm really excited about it, and I wanted my brand name to kind of look like that. I wanted to look like that, hey, that I'm doing something that's a little bit more broader, not just solely on virtual assistant work. So that's what I decided to do. I decided to go ahead and rebrand it, change my name, go ahead and get my project management certification, and go from there.
So do you enjoy the fact that you now have two services that you're offering? Project management and virtual assistant is the goal, right? That's
correct.
Really where you want to go. I think it's also interesting and something worth noting that both of the services she has complements one another. A good virtual assistant is a great project manager because it's all about deliverables. It's about time. It's about your ability to produce what's needed as you're moving forward. And as you're building. And I think it's interesting that that you decided, you know, what can I do that's going to complement this so I could take my strategy and business, you know, to the next level, you know, as you're doing that. So congratulations on being able to do that. Was it hard coming up with the new name?
It really wasn't. I like the word savvy, so I think it's very nice, and it's just very shway. So I decided to keep my name, Savvy Empire Consulting.
And where did Empire come from?
Well, it sounds grandiose. So that's why I chose Empire. It sounds big.
And so listen to this, though. What she's saying is important. I want to sound big. I want to sound savvy. I want something that people are going to be attracted to. As we all know, We are our brands. We are our brands that we walk within our business, and we want people to hear something and go, oh my gosh, I want to do that. That sounds really neat. I really want to be a part of that. You know, I want her services. I want to understand what she does and how she can build that capability moving forward. And so we begin to think about applying that brand and taking that brand to the next level. Did you come up with it on your own? Or did you hire a marketing person, or was it just something that was instinct?
I did come up with it on my own. I was in sales before, so I consider myself a little bit of a marketing expert, just a little bit. So I know a little bit about that. So that's why I decided that.
Well, that's awesome. Well, we're going to take a station break. When we come back, we're going to see if there's a question from the audience. We'll be right back.
Strategic Minds, Making Money Moves, with Vicki Wright Hamilton, focuses on helping entrepreneurs to overcome their business challenges to help increase their bottom line. Each episode provides strategies for growth and transformation. Watch Vicki share her 20-plus years of experience as a corporate executive to help entrepreneurs level up.
Welcome back. As you can see, Selena has gone through a major transition and transformed her company, not only from name and brand, but she's also added other complementary services that it will allow her the ability to upsell, right? So in terms of, I can do project management for you, I can be virtual assistant for you, and guess what? One skill complements another. And I think that's what's important, is that you chose things that complement each other so that they can support one another. You know, so many times we say to a business, you only need to do one thing. You got to do one thing well. But when you're able to complement each other in terms of what you're doing, you're offering a bigger solution to others as they get involved. Now, are you still a solopreneur, or do you have others working for you?
Right now, I'm still a solopreneur, but I am looking for a team. So that's coming very soon.
Okay, did you hear that? You heard it on this show first. She wants to build a team. And you know, it's interesting as we begin to talk about building teams, because there's so many different options out there, right? There's many other entrepreneurs that you could partner with. There's people who are interested in doing consulting that you can go and hire as a 1099 or bring them on, you know, as consulting and moving forward. So there's so many opportunities that allow you the ability to expand that. So I'm going to have to keep in touch, because I want to hear about the next phase as you continue to expand too, because I'm sure that's going to be very interesting. And going through, you know, that process of moving forward and doing that. How do you keep your virtual assistant skills up? What do you do in terms of being able to help and say, yes, I can do that. No, I can't do that.
Well, it really depends on the client that I currently have and what they need. I use Google a lot, and YouTube are my friends. I will find out how to figure out something, and everything is basically searchable online. Sometimes I would take certifications, like the current one that I'm taking right now. And there are a lot of administrative certifications that you can take online, free, or just take a simple class. So
what sort of other certifications do you have? I think it's great for them to understand all the tools you have in your toolbox.
Yes, ma'am. Well, I do have a paralegal certificate. I'm currently getting the project management professional certificate, and I'm looking forward to focus on risk management there as well, that certification. But currently I just have the two, working on that third one.
It's not just, don't ever say the word just. It's not just, you have accomplished something. You have made it happen. So own it, love it, and make it a part of you. We don't have to say just, you've come a long, long way. And it's been great to watch your journey as you have evolved in terms of moving forward and using the skills that you've been given, using the opportunities that you've been given, you know, to really say, oh, I'm gonna maximize this. And I think it's interesting you know, that you talk about, I have skill sets that, you know, in terms of what I do, I have done sales before, I have done this before. So don't let any of those competencies go by the wayside, right? Because they're all there to benefit you, you know, as you're moving forward and trying to build that business, even when it comes to looking to consultants, trying to find people on your team. They want to partner with people that they know are striving, that they're driving for success, that they're moving to that next level. They want to be associated with that, you know, brand too. Because there's times when you partner with people, they come in under your name. There's times you may partner with somebody else and go underneath their name. So we always want to make sure that we are able to give them something that says, be proud of this. So I want you to continue to be proud, you know, continue to celebrate that and be proud. And a paralegal too, okay, I need to write that down because I did not know you were a paralegal, but now I know, you know, so now I know something else of another service. I come to you and say, you know, I need help, you know, in terms of moving forward. But that's why it's so important, you know, as you begin to work with coaches, et cetera, that they know that, you know, these are things that you offer. That's phenomenal. Let's see if we have a question from our audience.
Hi, Selena. I love your business plan. And I know that you said that you source coaches, that you wanted to target coaches. How do you network to find clients in that industry?
Well, LinkedIn is my friend. I love LinkedIn. So I do a lot of networking through LinkedIn. A lot of my current clients right now, they've been wonderful and they've been through recommendation. But I do suggest people, LinkedIn is your friend. You don't throw away LinkedIn. Like, that is a very important professional tool that everyone needs in their toolbox. As well as Googling some networks that are in the area. There are certain associations, like the National Coaches Associations, that's out there. So you want to make sure that when you focus on your niche, you find out what they like and you like those things too.
Thank you so much for your question. And what she said is very, very important. You said you found out where your clients are and you became a part of that, right? Associations, please don't leave those out because they can be a opportunity for you to truly say, this is what I do and how I can help you. And it's applicable to everyone because they're part. That's the core of the association. That's why they exist. And I think there's something else that you said that's really, really important. It's LinkedIn. So how do you go about using LinkedIn? Is it that you look up a certain name, you look up a certain title? How do you use LinkedIn to benefit you?
Well, you can actually use everything that you said, those search queries, to find someone. But I started off in my network because LinkedIn, it's kind of similar to Facebook. You need an account and you do see people that you know, maybe in your phone book or in your contacts, and you connect with those people and they may know certain people. So you may reach out to them through a message. So it's just basic, just reaching out. It's online, so it's not as personal. So you want to make sure if you want to market to get an expert, if you're really serious about just marketing your services. But other than that, it's just a basic conversation saying, hello, how are you doing? And introducing yourself.
You know, and I think that's the key. You just said something, introducing yourself. And I know that on LinkedIn, a lot of times you get these emails. You get, I want to connect with you. I want to get to know you. I would really be interested in what your business, you know, what you do in your business. And so it is a professional network. You're absolutely right. And I think that it's key. And I think it guides us as to where we want to go. But it's all about connection. I'm connected to this person. You connected to that person. This person needs to know this person. Sometimes you'll get people in LinkedIn and say, can you please introduce me? And never, ever, ever not introduce someone to someone else. I think a lot of times we don't do that. And the deal is that connection may not just help the person you're introducing, but the person that you're introducing may be able to do something for you. So let's not forget, you know, let's help our entrepreneurs and our businesses and coworkers and team workers and all to be able to make that difference by helping others to connect to one another. Let's join me in thanking my guests today for coming in on another episode of Strategic Minds.
Thank you.
So thank you so much for joining us on another episode of Strategic Minds Making Money Moves, where we take those strategies and put them into practice so we can make that green. Look forward to seeing you soon. Thanks so much.